back to the Mr. Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a note sent in by Dan. Dan goes back to a podcast from a few weeks ago and says, hey, you really missed it. There was a better way to do that. And I love when I find better ways to do that. Dan said, you missed the mod function. And I want to just briefly talk about the mod function. Dan has a great point. He says, people don't think about it enough. And I want to explain to you briefly how the mod function works. I want you to go back to elementary school when you were first learning how to do division. Do you remember when you would have a problem like 14 divided by 5? And instead of providing a decimal, you would provide an answer that 5 goes into 14 two times with a remainder of 4. The mod function is a great way to provide the remainder. So I have a simple spreadsheet here, and going down column A, I've used a function called equal row. That gives me numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And maybe I'd like to use conditional formatting to set up some interesting banding formatting, where basically there's 3 rows that are colored and then 3 rows that are white. And so I want to try and figure out whether this is the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, or sixth row. And so what I do is I use the mod function. I say, I want the mod of that row number divided by 6. So mod, comma, 6. And what it does is it does the division, leaves off the integer portion of the quotient, and gives me just the remainder. So 1 divided by 6, 6 goes into 1 0 times with a remainder of 1. I get the answer of 1. What's interesting in this is when I get down to row 6, it gives me a remainder of 0. So quickly to show you how to do the conditional formatting, if I select several cells and use conditional formatting, say the formula is equal mod of row A1, comma 6, less than 3, choose a formatting, I'll choose a dark pattern here. Click OK, click OK. Very quickly we get the green bar effect with 3 rows on and 3 rows off. Simple enough. Well, Dan pointed out that way back in podcast 524, when we were trying to find out the last Saturday of the month, I ended up using this kind of clunky if statement at the end that says, hey, my formula is working great. Unless the last Saturday of the month is the last day of the month, then I have to subtract 7. Rather than use the weekday function and the if statement that I did back in podcast 524, Dan said this is a great opportunity to use the mod function. So I take the weekday of the end of month function divided by 7. If it happens to be exactly 7, which is what I was testing for in the if statement before, I get a 0 and I'm not subtracting an extra week. So I want to thank Dan for pointing out the mod function. It's a great function that I have to admit I don't think of enough. I think it was one of those hard concepts when we learned it in math, and it was called modulo back then, and it's now instituted in Excel in the mod function. And just think back to your very first days in division. It gives you the remainder. Anytime you're interested in the fractional portion after doing the division, the mod function is a great way to go. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.